by the love of the game itself. And after a decade at the top, Michael Jordan still plays basketball like a teenager.
What station is this?
You can make my day if you say good day, mate.
I've never seen anything quite like it. I mean, he literally, he'll walk into places and people will scream. And I've seen him walk into rooms and there's enough people, a certain number of people will start crying. A certain number of people will burst into tears.
One word, your best good day, mate.
Good day, mate.
People come down to see him now. He told me that some people don't get a chance to see him play a lot. So the guys that fight for the tickets, whether they're playing New Jersey or they're playing a team that's out of the playoffs, he tries to give that same type of performance so that guy that has waited one time to see Michael Jordan can tell his kids, I saw him and he was good.
He earns $100 every minute of every day of the year. He is the most famous basketballer who's ever played the game, the centerpiece of advertising campaigns the world over. Even Michael Jackson is happy to share center stage with big Michael Jordan. It ain't too hard for me to jam. 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 For all that magic and style, there's nothing intimidating about Michael Jordan.
Pretty pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's a great pleasure.
Michael Jordan for three. Yes!
In season 1993, Jordan led the American National Basketball Association in scoring for the seventh year in a row. He captained the Chicago Bulls to their third straight NBA championship. And for the third straight year, Michael Jordan was the man who made the difference.
What makes you different on the court, do you think? What gives you the... I mean, so many people have tried to assess what makes Mike Jordan the greatest player.
I enjoy the game. I don't take the game so serious that, you know, it becomes a business. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm doing something that I love and I get paid to do that. But if it wasn't for the money, I'd still play the game.
Sometimes I dream that he is me. Michael Jordan's appeal corresponds with the world push of the NBA, of basketball, and the hard sell of all sorts of products by sporting heroes. Recently, a poll of Australian school children rated Jordan as their most popular sportsman.
But to say that, you know, the kids in Australia has picked me as probably the most admired athlete is saying a lot, and, you know, I take pride in that. And even though I've never been to Australia, I mean, that's a privilege. That's a real big honor, and that's a heck of a pressure to deal with. But, it's not a bad pressure to have. I'm very happy for that, and hopefully I can get the chance to visit Australia and give them an up-close and personal type of look at Michael Jordan and the type of person that he is.
Jordan's a natural, one of the sweetest movies you'd ever see. The contest revolves around him. The ball seems to chase him about the court. His capacity to score the big basket, legendary.
There's a lot of pro basketball players and a lot of famous athletes in America. But there's nobody that gets the kind of reaction that Michael does, and yet he's got to figure it out himself. There's no Elvis to say, I went through this type of thing, here's how you do it. So to me, what I found in writing Hang Time, that the most interesting, as interesting as it is to watch Jordan on the basketball court, which is very interesting, to me, Jordan on the road, behind closed doors, door locked, phone off the hook, his feet up on the table, trying to figure out what this thing is he's going through and trying to make sense out of this life he's living, to me, that Michael Jordan is even more interesting and in a way more impressive than the basketball player.
You'd wonder whether all the hype, the spotlight, gets to Jordan, whether the pressure and lack of privacy wears him down.
What about this feeling when you're out or even playing basketball? Do you ever feel as if nobody's eyes are on you, or do you always feel them burning through you, the eyes of the world?
When I'm playing, I don't worry about the eyes. You know, I'm worried about the competition and the fun that I'm doing or I'm having. I don't worry about the fans and their eyes on me. You know, it's the competition that really drives me to be the player that I am. So I really don't get into, who's watching me, who's paying attention to me, who's watching every move that I'm doing. I'm just out there playing the game.
But Jordan doesn't treat the game lightly. He wants to win. He drives his teammates hard. Some say he runs the balls ruthlessly, demanding the ball, expecting the focus to be on Michael Jordan. Despite Jordan's magnificent performances, the Chicago press hasn't always been favourable.
It's this whole thing of a tall poppy syndrome, isn't it, where you're on top and people want to knock you down. And I guess you've noticed over the years even a subtle change in the media's reaction towards you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's very, very common. It's just human nature that once you get to a pinnacle of your life and you can't really extend any further, it's hard to maintain that level. I mean, because certainly people get tired of hearing your name, seeing your pictures all over the place, and that's just human nature. I've accepted that.
It's been Michael Jordan's addiction to golf and his love of gambling that has cost him hundreds of thousands of dollars. He's been publicly rebuked by NBA boss David Stern.
You've had very little controversy surrounding your life. Well, one was a betting accusation a couple of years ago. How do you handle things like that?
Well, I think I've led a very positive life. And yeah, naturally, you're going to have some things that I've done wrong that most people have done. The gambling thing is something that kind of got out of proportion. And yeah, I took my punishment in that situation. I dealt with it. But most of my life is just as normal as it can be. You know, I think I'm an easy guy to get along with. I'm a people type of person. And, my life is no different than the next person. So I think it's kind of understandable when people see me out doing things that, hey, he's not doing nothing that no one else probably would be doing.
Across the universe, people are asking, what fiend would steal Air Jordan?
Despite the controversy and the headlines, the sponsors have stuck with him. Nike International pay him $35 million to spearhead their footwear and apparel ranges.
Pebble Beach!
This is no way for a pampered superstar to travel.
What the?
Air Jordan products are marketed in 80 countries. In the USA alone, the sneaker market is worth $15 billion annually. This is big business. Too big for a few missed putts to put at risk a hugely successful marketing strategy.
Mr. Network says no splattering.
The endorsements, commercials, appearances and business deals guarantee him $50 million annually. Only $6 million coming from the Chicago Bulls. The influential business magazine Forbes says he's the highest paid athlete on earth and the first non-boxer to head the list. In his wake, a former heavyweight champ Evander Holyfield, racing drivers Ayrton Senna and Nigel Mansell, and he earns three times as much as Greg Norman.
It's a heck of a responsibility. I mean, it isn't something that I woke up one morning and I went out and I campaigned for it. You know, next thing you know, I was bestowed this, and I think it's a heck of a privilege to have, but it's a heck of a responsibility to carry on.
Have you ever been asked to endorse products that would seem...
out of my personality, yeah. Beer commercials, different type of food products that I don't really eat and I didn't want to endorse, just to name a few.
This is for your Big Mac, right? First one that misses?
Watches the winner eat lunch, got it.
Off the glass.
This stunning commercial, featuring Jordan and his old pal Larry Bird, is part of McDonald's massive advertising campaign in the USA.
Off the scoreboard, off the bang board, no rim.
Over the second rafter, off the floor, nothing but net. Through the window, off the wall, nothing but net.
I guess my personality has fit their bill of what they expect from me. And I think the success has come from that.
Off the expressway, over the river, off the billboard, through the window, off the wall,
Nothing but net.
Last month, Jordan's perfect world fell apart when his father James was murdered while resting in his luxury car beside a highway not far from his home in North Carolina.
I was ready to go home. My family is my stability, and all before I got married and had my family, the public and the media got 95% of my time. Now it's reversed.
The second youngest of five children, Jordan has maintained the tight family unit. His parents had worked in Jordan businesses, along with brother Larry and sister Rosalind. He is a man who escapes the limelight with wife Juanita, boys Marcus and Jeffrey, and daughter Jasmine.
Well, that's probably the best thing about my life is that, you know, I do have time. I make time for my kids and for my family. And no matter how bad my day is on the basketball court, when I come home, you know, it's just a ray of sunshine for me because my kids are always in a good mood, and usually my wife is in a good mood, and it's a great family atmosphere, and it's really a good balance for the job and for the hype and the situation that I deal with every day.
Do you think your children are old enough now to know that Dad's slightly different to the normal Dad?
My oldest is starting to get a good feel for that. My 2-year-old and my youngest are not, but my oldest are pretty much starting to pick up with the notoriety of his dad, and certainly I try to be as normal as possible with him, but when I'm out, sometimes the public tends to treat me a little bit more different than he sees me, and that's pretty much something that he's starting to learn, and I don't want him to get caught up in the stardom stuff. I just want him to know me as his father.
No surprise the kids know their dad is different. As well as the TV ads and the billboards, Michael Jordan is rapidly closing on Muhammad Ali's record of 31 Sports Illustrated covers. After the 93 playoffs, Jordan had been on the cover of the US Sports Bible 28 times. It's a fair bet that he'll be the new standard bearer, passing the man who's been a hero to blacks and whites, not just athletes, all over the world.
I think he crossed many, many barriers, many lines, as well as Arthur Ashe. I think both of those were pioneers in the sense to see these people viewed as people instead of as races or color or whatever. And I think that's my ultimate goal is to be viewed as a person first. And even though I know that my race is black, but I'm a person just like you and any other person. And if you can see me as that, then I think you make a big step towards curing racism in this world.
Like that?
No, this finger here.
Oh, just the one? Okay.
Yeah, but feel all the energy coming through you, like a rocket coming out of your brain. Right. Hold it. Wham! Just throw it out. Now, as this foot comes back, this the other one goes up and...
I think I got it. Yeah. It's too hard for me to...
It's a lot. Need a jam.
It ain't too hard for me to jam. It ain't too hard for me to jam.
Do this.
Yeah. It ain't too hard for me to jam. It ain't too hard for me to jam.
You got it.
Yeah, I think it ain't too hard for me to jam.
Yeah.
It ain't too hard for me to jam.
You got it.
Wait, what's so funny?
We're going to play some basketball.
In whatever he does, whether it be on the golf course, around the baskets, even dancing with Michael Jackson, Michael Jordan is so competitive. And at the top, that's what makes the difference. That's what makes Jordan fly.
Is it on you, or do you always feel them burning through you, the eyes of the world?
When I'm playing, I don't worry about the eyes. You know, I'm worried about the competition and the fun that I'm doing or I'm having. I really don't worry about the fans and their eyes on me. You know, it's a competition that really drives me to be the player that I am. So I really don't get into who's watching me, who's paying attention to me, who's watching every move that I'm doing. I'm just out there playing the game.
But Jordan doesn't treat the game lightly. He wants to win. He drives his teammates hard. Some say he runs the Bulls ruthlessly, demanding the ball, expecting the focus to be on Michael Jordan. Despite Jordan's magnificent performances, the Chicago press hasn't always been favourable.
It's this whole thing of a tall poppy syndrome, isn't it, where you're on top and people want to knock you down. And I guess you've noticed over the years even a subtle change in the media's reaction towards you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's very, very common. It's just human nature that once you get to a pinnacle of your life and you can't really extend any further, it's hard to maintain that level. I mean, because certainly people get tired of hearing your name, seeing your pictures all over the place. And that's just human nature. I've accepted that.
It's been Michael Jordan's addiction to golf and his love of gambling that has cost him hundreds of thousands of dollars. He's been publicly rebuked by NBA boss David Stern.
You've had very little controversy surrounding your life. Well, one was a betting accusation a couple of years ago. How do you handle things like that?
Well, I think I've led a very positive life. And yeah, naturally, you're going to have some things that I've done wrong that most people have done. The gambling thing is something that kind of got out of proportion. And yeah, I took my punishment in that situation. I dealt with it. But most of my life is as normal as it can be. You know, I think I'm an easy guy to get along with. I'm a people type of person. And, you know, my life is no different than the next person. So I think it's kind of understandable when people see me out doing things that, hey, he's not doing nothing that no one else probably would be doing.
Across the universe, people are asking, what fiend would steal air?
Off the wall, nothing but net.
Last month, Jordan's perfect world fell apart when his father James was murdered while resting in his luxury car beside a highway not far from his home in North Carolina.
I was ready to go home. My family's my stability. And all before I got married and had my family, the public and the media got 95% of my time. Now it's reversed.
The second youngest of five children, Jordan has maintained the tight family unit. His parents had worked in Jordan businesses, along with brother Larry and sister Roslyn. He is a man who escapes the limelight with wife Juanita, boys Marcus and Jeffrey, and daughter Jasmine.
Well, that's probably the best thing that about my life is that, you know, I do have time. I make time for my kids and for my family. And no matter how bad my day is on the basketball court, when I come home, you know, it's just a ray of sunshine for me because my kids are always in a good mood, and you know, usually my wife is in a good mood, and it's a great family atmosphere. And it's really a good balance for the job and for the hype and the situation that I deal with every day.
Do you think your children are old enough now to know that Dad's slightly different to the normal Dad?
My oldest is starting to get a good feel for that. My 2-year-old and my youngest are not, but my oldest are pretty much starting to pick up with the notoriety of his dad. And, you know, certainly I try to be as normal as possible with him. But when I'm out, sometimes the public tends to treat me a little bit more different than, you know, he sees me. And, you know, that's pretty much something that he's starting to learn. And I don't want him to get caught up in the stardom stuff. I just want him to know me as his father.
No surprise the kids know their dad is different. As well as the TV ads and the billboards, Michael Jordan is rapidly closing on Muhammad Ali's record of 31 Sports Illustrated covers. After the 93 playoffs, Jordan had been on the cover of the US Sports Bible 28 times. It's a fair bet that he'll be the new standard bearer, passing the man who's been a hero to blacks and whites, not just athletes, all over the world. By the love of the game itself, and after a decade at the top, Michael Jordan still plays basketball like a teenager.
What station is this?
You can make my day if you say, good day, mate.
I've never seen anything quite like it. I mean, he literally, he'll walk into places and people will scream. And I've seen him walk into rooms and there's enough people. A certain number of people will start crying. A certain number of people will burst into tears.
One more. Oh, your best good day, mate.
Good day, mate.
People come down to see him now. He told me that some people don't get a chance to see him play a lot. So the guys that fight for the tickets, whether they're playing New Jersey or they're playing a team that's out of the playoffs, he tries to give that same type of performance, so that guy that has waited one time to see Michael Jordan can tell his kids, I saw him and he was good.
He earns $100 every minute of every day of the year. He is the most famous basketballer who's ever played the game, the centerpiece of advertising campaigns the world over. Even Michael Jackson is happy to share center stage with big Michael Jordan. It ain't too hard for me to jam. 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 For all that magic and style, there's nothing intimidating about Michael Jordan.
Great pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's a great pleasure.
Michael Jordan for three. Yes.
In season 1993, Jordan led the American National Basketball Association in scoring for the seventh year in a row. He captained the Chicago Bulls to their third straight NBA championship. And for the third straight year, Michael Jordan was the man who made the difference.
No, he could not get it all knocked away by Grant. It's all over. The Chicago Bulls have three straight NBA championships.
What makes you different on the court, do you think? What gives you the swing? So many people have tried to assess what makes Mike Jordan the greatest player.
I enjoy the game. I don't take the game so serious that, you know, it becomes a business. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm doing something that I love and I get paid to do that. But if it wasn't for the money, I'd still play the game.
Sometimes I dream he is me. Michael Jordan's appeal corresponds with the world push of the NBA, of basketball, and the hard sell of all sorts of products by sporting heroes. Recently, a poll of Australian school children rated Jordan as their most popular sportsman.
But to say that, you know, the kids in Australia has picked me as probably the most admired athlete is saying a lot, and, you know, I take pride in that. And even though I've never been to Australia, I mean, that's a privilege. That's a real big honor, and that's a heck of a pressure to deal with. But, it's not a bad pressure to have. I'm very happy for that, and hopefully I can get the chance to visit Australia and give them an up-close and personal type of look at Michael Jordan and the type of person that he is.
Jordan's a natural, one of the sweetest movies you'd ever see. The contest revolves around him. The ball seems to chase him about the court. His capacity to score the big basket, legendary.
There's a lot of pro basketball players and a lot of famous athletes in America. But there's nobody that gets the kind of reaction that Michael does, and yet he's got to figure it out himself. There's no Elvis to say, I went through this type of thing, here's how you do it. So to me, what I found in writing Hang Time, that the most interesting, as interesting as it is to watch Jordan on the basketball court, which is very interesting, to me, Jordan on the road, behind closed doors, door locked, phone off the hook, his feet up on the table, trying to figure out what this thing is he's going through and trying to make sense out of this life he's living. To me, that Michael Jordan is even more interesting and in a way more impressive than the basketball player.
You'd wonder whether all the hype, the spotlight, gets to Jordan, whether the pressure and lack of privacy wears him down.
What about this feeling when you're out or even playing basketball? Do you ever feel as if nobody's eyes...
Despite the controversy and the headlines, the sponsors have stuck with him. Nike International pay him $35 million to spearhead their footwear and apparel ranges.
Pebble Beach!
This is no way for a pampered superstar to travel.
What the?
Air Jordan products are marketed in 80 countries. In the USA alone, the sneaker market is worth $15 billion annually. This is big business. Too big for a few missed putts to put at risk a hugely successful marketing strategy.
Mr. Networks has no splattering.
Hey! The endorsements, commercials, appearances and business deals guarantee him $50 million annually, only $6 million coming from the Chicago Bulls. The influential business magazine Forbes says he's the highest paid athlete on earth and the first non-boxer to head the list. In his wake, a former heavyweight champ Evander Holyfield, racing drivers Ayrton Senna and Nigel Mansell, and he earns three times as much as Greg Norman.
It's a heck of a responsibility. I mean, it isn't something that I woke up one morning and I went out and I campaigned for it. You know, next thing you know, I was bestowed this, and I think it's a heck of a privilege to have, but it's a heck of a responsibility to carry on.
Have you ever been asked to endorse products that would seem...
out of my personality, yeah. Beer commercials, different type of food products that I don't really eat and I didn't want to endorse, just to name a few.
This is for your Big Mac, right? First one that misses?
Watches the winner eat lunch, got it.
Off the glass.
This stunning commercial, featuring Jordan and his old pal Larry Bird, is part of McDonald's massive advertising campaign in the USA.
Off the scoreboard, off the bang board, no rim.
Over the second rafter, off the floor, nothing but net. Through the window, off the wall, nothing but net.
I guess my personality has fit their bill of what they expect from me. And I think the success has come from that.
Off the expressway, over the river, off the billboard, through the window.